wrestling's a great thing to watch when you want to get out of reality and just turn on the TV and, you know, watch some of the crazy drama that goes on. We're bringing that to you in the game.
The things that I'm proud about WCW NWO Thunder are the details. The way the characters leave the ring, the way they come in, and it really brings the whole experience of, you know, being at a wrestling event into your living room.
You and your buddy can go at it and just pound each other all day, you know, take out your frustrations, and I think that's important in video games.
Getting to go out there and beat people up for a living and not get thrown in jail. That has to be one of the best, my most favorite thing about being a wrestler, for sure.
Oh boy, WCW and NWO Thunder. You know, I love the game. I play it with my mother-in-law. No, I don't cheat. Please don't ever accuse me of that. I understand right now, back in the locker room area here at the Ice Palace in Tampa, Florida, we have a couple of members of the NWO, Vincent and the Giant. And what, are we catching him in the heat of battle? Please.
How do I get out of this?
It's just like real life, I'm killing you.
For the gamers that have played WCW Nitro on the PlayStation, Thunder is definitely an upgrade in terms of the speed of the gameplay. It's a lot faster than Nitro's engine was. There's more moves per character. There's more characters. They've all been updated.
Pick me, or I'll stick your head through the mat.
Can you dig it, sucker? The torture is gonna last longer on the Hollywood Walk of Shame.
You'll find out who's next.
There's additional modes. There's the ability to take a weapon and bring it into the ring and use it against your opponent, as, you know, fans see on television. Nitro, awesome game. I mean, just phenomenal for its time. But Thunder is just night and day compared to it.
This is our first game with the cage match in it, and you know, it was fun making that. You can throw him into the side of the cage and knock him out, and you can climb up the cage and jump off and do elbow drops and all those fun moves.
There's just a lot that Thunder offers to the WCW hardcore fan. There's a Battle Royal mode.
Powerbomb!
Battle Royal is brutal because you gotta have eyes in the back of your head.
We didn't use motion capture. Basically, every move is done frame by frame by hand, following a video image. If you motion capture a character, he looks stiff. It might look good on TV, but it doesn't look good in the game. When you're making a wrestling game, you have to exaggerate even more to make it look good in the game. We had this backbreaking move, so we took an apple and kind of crunched on an apple for a while, and we thought it was funny, so we left it in the game.
That's sweet. Ooh, what a punch to the face.
That's the strike.
The best way to get good at Thunder is to have a wrestler sitting by you, behind you, just directing you, telling you what to do, and pointing out stuff. The second best thing is to learn the moves, get in there with a powerful wrestler, say a Saturn or a Goldberg, and really get to know that character. We also include a list of moves in the instruction manual so that the gamer who maybe isn't a wrestling fanatic and doesn't know that, you know, Sting should normally do the Scorpion Deathlock, it's all laid out for them on paper. Go out there and experiment and have fun, and you're going to learn the tricks and the tips.
Mean Gene back here for PlayStation Underground. I understand that there may be a major upset in the making between the Giant and Vincent. Let's check it out.
Boom! Oh! That's bomb!
All right, shoot him!
Okay, I won't do it no more. Okay, yeah.
Hey, yo, yo!
Don't get upset, man. It's just a game, man.
Yo, yo, yo! I'm out of here.
Ooh! He got a bad attitude. What an attitude! And a new TV.
Thunder really brings the whole experience of, you know, being at a wrestling event, being at that WCW Monday Nitro event or Thursday Thunder event into your living room.